Hello students, today we are going to study the basic concepts of gene cloning. Today we are going to study gene cloning. I am Akanksha Jain, Assistant Professor, School of Biosciences, IMS Ghaziabad. First, let's get introduced with the term cloning. The term cloning, it is derived from a Greek word klon, which means twig. Now, twig is actually like creating the number of copies of a plant. Cloning exactly means making genetically identical copies. In molecular biology lab, we are actually doing cloning of a piece of a DNA fragment. And so basically cloning is making number of copies. It can be any piece of DNA, for example, any coding sequence or something like that. So gene cloning, it's a process of making multiple copies of same gene. Now we come to the basic steps of gene cloning. First, we need to identify the DNA that we want to clone. So it has to be isolated from the genetic material. This genetic isolated fragment of DNA, it's combined with a vehicle which we call as vector. And now this vector is introduced into the organism. Now the next step comes is selection of that recombinant colony. So this is the figure which shows how a recombinant DNA molecule is actually introduced into the host and then selected. So first, as you can see here, it is a vector, which is a vehicle which will carry this fragment of DNA. When this fragment of DNA combines with a vector, it forms a recombinant DNA molecule. Now this recombinant DNA molecule, this is introduced into the bacteria, which is a host for this recombinant DNA molecule. This figure shows how this bacteria is carrying a recombinant DNA molecule, and a bacteria has to be competent enough to carry this plasmid. Once the desired plasmid, recombinant plasmid, is inserted into the bacteria, it is then allowed, the host is allowed to multiply, and we have number of recombinant molecule. As you can see how this single plasmid is now converted into number of recombinant molecules. Once we have a number of copies of this recombinant DNA molecule, we divide, the cell division take place, and now we have more number of copies. Now once we have sufficient number of colonies, the next step is the selection of the recombinant colonies from the transformed ones. From that I mean that there may be some cells which are transformed, means they have the plasmid, but the plasmid don't carry the fragment of interest. So those colonies has to be selected from the non-transformed colonies. So this is how the process, these are the basic steps which shows how we construct a recombinant DNA molecule and how this actually multiplies in the host and then how the colonies are selected. So this was the basic steps of gene cloning.